And this problem will also be working with the null space of a matrix. It's a little bit different from the first example problem we worked, though. In the first example problem, we were just wanting to figure out, is this vector in the null space? In this example problem, we're going to more fully characterize all the vectors in the null space of a given matrix. So the matrix we're going to work with in this problem is a 3x4 matrix A, and here is the matrix. And what we would like to do is we would like to find a full description of its null space. So we would like to be able to characterize kind of all the elements of the null space of A. And we're going to do that by finding a set of vectors that span the null space. So we would like to find the set of vectors that span the null space, and that will be our full description of every possible vector that can be in the null space. Because remember, the span of a set of vectors is all linear combinations. So we're going to go ahead and find a compact way to write this infinite collection of vectors that comprise the null space of A. So remember what the null space means. I'm trying to find the set of vectors such that AX equals 0. So that's what I need to find. I need to find all the vectors X that satisfy this equation. So what I can do is I can just go ahead and set up an augmented matrix. So there's my matrix A, and I've augmented it with the vector 0, 0, 0, because I'm trying to find all solutions of this system of equations. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and just do very basic row operations to actually solve this augmented matrix. So if I let equation 2 equal equation 2 plus 3 times equation 1, and equation 3 I'll replace with equation 3 minus 2 times equation 1, I can simplify things a little bit. Equation 1 doesn't change at all, but equation 2 simplifies to this, and equation 3 simplifies to this. So this is just the standard row operation stuff that we had videos on earlier in the playlist. And then let's go ahead and replace E3 with 2E3 plus E2. And equations 1 and 2 won't change, but now equation 3 looks like this. And again, all I'm trying to do is get down to this reduced form where I can pick off the solution easily. If I replace E2 with 1/6 E2, I can turn that into a 1, which was something I would like to do. So equations 1 and 3 don't change, but equation 2 now transforms into this. And now, I like this form. I can look at this. I have some pivots right here, obviously, in the first two columns. So those are my basic variables. X1 and X2 are basic variables. But X3 and X4, since they don't have pivots, those are going to be free variables. So this system of equations is very much overdetermined. I only have 3 equations, but 4 unknowns. We knew something like this would happen. I'd end up with some free variables. So since I have free variables X3 and X4, I want to write my solution in terms of those. So if I look at that top row really says that X1 equals 2x3 minus 6x4. And the second row says that x2 equals a negative 2x4. And then x3 and x4 are free because they are the free variables in this system of equations. So going from the kind of matrix notation back to the equation notation, so to speak, is kind of nice at this point because it tells me very explicitly what each coordinate of my solution is going to be equal to. Writing it this way is nice too, because now I can go ahead and think about how I might write the general solution in terms of my free variables. The general solution, which I'll go ahead and denote as the vector x, will be equal to x3 times 2, 0, 1, 0, plus x4 times a negative 6, negative 2, 0, 1. So any solution to this augmented matrix is always going to have this form. And you can see what I've done. I've written it in terms of the free variables x3 and x4 just by looking at this side of the equation. x1 has 2 x3s. That's why it has a 2 up here. And it has minus 6 x4s, which is why there is a minus 6 right here. And you just do the same thing for the other variables. So I've been able to write the null space of my matrix, the general solution for all the vectors in the null space, as a linear combination of two vectors. So what that really means is that my null space is really the span of those two vectors, 2, 0, 1, 0, minus 6, 2, 0, 1. Because remember, this is a linear combination of these vectors. It consists of all linear combinations because x3 and x4 are free. So that is the same thing as the span of those vectors. So I've been able to find a full characterization of my null space. My null space of this matrix is really the span of these two vectors, and the span is an infinite collection. It's all possible linear combinations of these two things. Since my null space can be written as the span of two vectors, the dimension of my null space is of size 2. So we say this is a two-dimensional null space because there's really two vectors that characterize it by the span.